chord.
In 1956, San Francisco-born Olympic-trained athlete Johnny Mathis chose to follow a singing career rather than pursue his talents as a high jumper, hurdler, and basketball player. The sporting world's loss was undeniably show business's gain, because for 25 years, since his first records, Teacher Teacher, A Certain Smile, and Wonderful Wonderful appeared in the record charts here in Britain, he has been singing his way into the hearts of the audiences and the fans who pack out his concert tours and buy his records worldwide. Perhaps, as one critic recently suggested, it is his stylistic constancy, acceptable risk, and instantly identifiable voice that have carried him so successfully through a quarter of a century. His own careful and personal selection of songs, always of quality, blend romantic standards with today's new and more contemporary music. A combination of the star and his talents that together have created the Mathis magic.
To the ends of the earth, I'll follow my star. To the ends of the earth, just to be where you are. No matter where you roam, I'll never be far behind. Cares where the path may lie, as long as I find you. Though the melody dies, the song lingers on, and a thousand goodbyes won't convince me you're gone. To the ends of the earth, till you've given your love to me. To the ends of the earth, I'll follow my star. To the ends of the earth, just to be where you are. No matter where you roam, I'll never be far behind. As long as I find, though the melody dies, the song lingers on, and a thousand goodbyes won't convince me you're gone. I'll follow you, my love, you'll never be free. To the end of the earth, though we try to be masters of our souls and captains of our fate, it's the lucky ones who achieve their goals while others have to wait. Our destiny is mostly bought and paid for us. The really big decisions all are made for us. So it's not for me to say you love me. It's not for me to say you always care. glow of love will grow with every passing day. Oh, we may never meet again, but then it's not for me to say. Chances are, 'cause I wear a silly grin the moment you come into view. Chances are you think that I'm in love with you. Just because sort of slips the moment that your lips meet mine. Well, chances are you think you're my Valentine, and chances are your chances are.
I will go to my grave wondering why they think it's so important to know about me instead of what I do, because I'm not very interesting at all. my life is really quite an open book. I spend most of my time in the public eye, and the rest of the time I spend cooking and playing golf. That's pretty dull.
Well, have you got any idea how many records you've made over the years?
I think I know approximately how many I've made. I've made about 85 albums.
Maybe.
But it's difficult to say because they take a whole collection of songs, and then they'll make a new album out of them, and that, I guess that counts as an album. Certainly does in Great Britain, because I think out of the last three or four albums that I've made, maybe three of them have been collections of songs that I've recorded earlier. Yeah. But at least 100 million records, which is, it's like something that I don't even believe. But that's about what has happened so far. But I'm interested, really, in what's going to happen from now on. Because I think this is the true test. I've had a great deal of good fortune, and I was blessed with a lot of good teachers, good producers and directors. And now they're almost all gone. Well, my teachers are dead. My producers are like, movie stars or something. They come in and they're very flamboyant and they're famous, and then they sort of disappear and someone else takes their place. And that's sort of what's happened. And so I think a lot is going to depend upon me as a person and from now on to see just what I can make out of this thing.
When they begin to begin, it brings back the sound of music so tender. It brings back a night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen. With you once more under the stars, and down by the shore an orchestra's playing, and even the palms seem to be swaying. Well, they began the beginning. Again, it's past all endeavor, except when the tune clutches my heart. And there we are, swearing to love forever, and promising never, ever to part. Divine, of rapture sweet, till the clouds came along to disperse the joys we have tasted. Now when I hear people curse the chance that was wasted, sleep like the dead desire I only remember. When they begin, they'll begin. Oh yes, let them begin the beginning. Let them play till the stars are there before return above you. Till you whisper to me once more.
Johnny first visited Britain in 1961 and has been returning here on a more or less annual basis ever since. This is his 12th nationwide tour of sell-out concerts, which this time began in Brighton. Every new visit means rehearsals for his own personal rhythm section and the rest of the orchestra of British musicians. Johnny always attends these rehearsals to familiarize himself not only with the new orchestra, but the acoustics of the concert hall or theater. Personal lighting and sound technicians carry out their preparations for the opening night, while Jim Gandulia briefs and rehearses the orchestra.
Which is the front half of the show, followed by the chorus line medley. The next tune up will be Begin the Beguine. Now, what are we substituting for Strangers? Anything?
Never Let Me Go.
Okay, take Never Let Me Go and put it in this place, followed by Misty.
Oh, wait a minute.
Beautiful evening is those two.
I might do Memories, Jimmy, as an encore. Maybe. If I do it.
Okay. Take Memories then and put it right after the I Will Survive bow. Are our microphones working? Okay.
You're 2 minutes too late. All the magic is gone.
From the top, I Believe in Love, everybody. One, two. We had a couple entrances there. Remember, this sign will be bar A, regardless of what kind of weirdness goes on up front of that. When I do this, we're at letter A. Okay.
Hey, Keith? Did you get those reeds changed? Let me check them. Reed one. Give me read two.
Let's take 10, everybody, okay?
Okay. That's still on read two. That should be read one.
Fix him too, will you? You gotta take care of these guys.
It sounds real heavy. And what I want it to be is light and crisp.
Guys, everybody, guys, just leave. We're gonna rehearse something here, okay? No playing, please. I mean, don't go too far. Okay. Right from the top. Okay, here we go.
And I think for the in-person thing, I think we should sing it a little slower. I think. Let's try it just a little slower, okay?
This tune?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Here we go. One, two, three, four.
You couldn't hurt me, could you?
Yeah.
You'd never leave me, would you?
Yeah, you may just have to slap it just a little bit more, but that's all right.
But I like that slower tempo, Jimmy, okay?
Yeah, fine.
Never let me go. Love me much too much. If you let me go, life would lose its touch. What would I be without you? There's no place for me without you. Never let me go. I'd be so lost. There'd be a thousand hours in the day without you. I know, because because of one caress, my world was overturned. At the very start, all my bridges burned by my flaming heart. You'd never leave me, would you? You couldn't hurt me, could you? Never let me go. Never let me go. Never leave me, would you? You couldn't hurt me, could you? Never let me go. Never let me. Beautiful evening. What a beautiful evening. It's a beautiful evening for falling in love. The moon wings his eyes. That this is the night for you and me. And soft as a willow, every cloud is our pillow, and all heaven and earth know what we're thinking of. Darling, they're so right, so kiss and hold.
Most of the fans that we've spoken to have a very clear idea about a favourite song. Mm. Do you have a favourite song from all those that you've sung?
Well, I still think that Misty is the kind of song and the kind of feeling that I would like to have people to feel when I sing, and I guess perhaps because I keep mentioning it, I do think that one will be the one that I sing to my grave. You know, you're going to be stuck with something like that. I've sort of shied away from some of the others that that vocally were so taxing. And let's face it, I did them when my voice was quite different from what it is now. So I'm really not able to sing some of the ones that I sang at an early age. Maria still traumatizes me because I can sing the whole song and I get to the end and I've got to sing that one little last high, soft note. And I did it for years and years and years. Now I'm not quite sure whether I can do it or not. Sometimes I can do it, sometimes I can't. But with Misty, I'm always kind of certain that even when I'm 70 years old, somehow I can sort of grunt it out.
As a kitten up a tree, and I feel like I'm clinging to a cloud I can't understand. I get misty just holding your hand. Walk my way, and a thousand violins begin to play. This might be the sound of your hello, that music I hear. I get misty the moment you're here. You can say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following. I wander through this wonderland alone, never knowing my right foot from my left, my hat from my glove. I'm too misty, too much in love. You can say that you're leading me, want you to do.
corner of an empty eye, empty spaces, where there used to be a soul inside. Nothing that no one ever gets to them, seems the wind could blow right through them. Believing in gods that never knew them, I believe in love. I believe in love, I do. I believe in feeling good. I'm feeling good. Money tree, you've got to hurry. Monkey do what the monkey see. You're on a one-way street and you're speeding. This is the sign you should be reading. Got some things you'll later be needing. I believe in love. I believe it. Nobody told me, always knew it. Nobody sold me. I believe in someone to hold me. I believe in love. I believe in love. I do. I believe in feeling good. Sleeping in an empty bed shouldn't be only just a place to rest my head. But I don't want to find myself one day waking up and looking at that Monday. So what's your name up on Sunday? I believe in love. I believe it. Nobody told me, always knew it. Nobody sold me. I believe in someone to hold me. I believe in love. I believe in love. I do. I believe in feeling good.
Have been periods in my life when I couldn't find a decent song because most of the people who were writing these wonderful songs decided that instead of giving them to the artist, they would perform them themselves, like Carl Barry Sager, Marvin Hamlisch, Paul Williams.
So the singer-songwriter revolution of the 70s was bad news for people,
right? It was terrible for me, and I spent a great deal of time out of my country, touring the world, because there was nothing else to do. I had no music to perform.
Do you ever get tired of songs? I mean, the same songs.
Oh, yeah. And then, you know what I do? And I didn't think it would work, but it does. It really has worked. It's a secret. I went
not anymore, isn't it?
I know it won't go beyond this room.
Fine.
I went back, and I said, all these songs, because I've always admired people like Nat King Cole, who passed away not maybe 15 years ago. And I said, merely because he's dead doesn't mean his music isn't any good anymore. So I went back and I got some of these old songs that I had recorded 20 years ago, 18 years ago. And I just brought them back exactly the way they had been recorded and started performing them again. And people think they're actually new arrangements of songs they've never heard, because there's a whole generation of people who really had to learn about Johnny Mathis from their parents.
They try to tell us we're too young. Too young. Begin to know the meaning of
were not too young. Must I explain? I need you, oh my darling, like roses need rain. You ask how long I love you. I'll tell you true until the 12th of never. I'll still be loving you. Bluebells forget to bloom. I love you till the clover has lost its perfume. I love you till the poets run out of rhyme, until the 12th of never, and that's a long, long time. Until the 12th of never, and that's a long
Thank you, Gil.
Our day will come, and we'll have everything. We'll share the joy all in love can bring. No one can tell us that I'm too young to know. I love you so, and you love me. If we just wait a while, we'll share the joy falling in love can bring. Our dreams have magic because we'll always stay in love this way. Our day will come. Our day will come, and we'll have everything. We'll share the joy. Mm-hmm.
many lovely things. Suddenly you know why my heart sings. You love a while, and when love goes, you try to hide the tears inside with a cheerful pose. But in the hush of night, exactly that certain smile to haunt your heart again. Comes that certain smile to haunt
Johnny, there's an extra little bonus to this opportunity to have a chat with you, because the very first record I ever bought, I hate to think how old I was Certain Smile. Mm-hmm. Like a fool, I haven't brought it along for you to autograph it. But that was a long time ago, and you've been going a very, very long time. Is there any one thing that you can put your finger on that explains the success over such a long period?
Well, I've wondered about it myself. I used to dream or fantasize about singing a song in a movie like A Certain Smile. But that's all it was. It was a dream. And my father used to tell me that if I went to school and if I went to my voice lessons and studied, that it would, that who knows what could happen. But that was my father talking, you know. I said, oh, what does he know? You know, he's my father. I knew him very well. But there's no reason to explain the success that I've had, except to say that it's been like a dream. Mm. I wanted just to sing, and I was very content to sing all these wonderful songs that were eventually written for me.
But if you're honest with yourself, did you really want to be a famous singer? I mean, many people like to sing, but is fame an aim for you?
I wanted to sing. I wanted never, ever to be famous. And I didn't quite know how to go about singing and not, if I had some success, not taking advantage of it. And it's been a constant... it's been something that I've had to put up with all my life, being in the public, because I'm nervous, I'm insecure, I'm shy, and not at all comfortable singing in front of people. It's something I've had to get quite accustomed to, but it's something that I've never really enjoyed.
But you come from a fairly large family, so why insecurity? You would expect that with a close relationship with your parents as you had, and with three brothers and three sisters, that you would be grateful for the family atmosphere, and you wouldn't necessarily worry.
Well, I'm grateful, and I'm sincere in my feelings about my parents and about their their attitudes toward me, but there is no way in the world to explain to another human being why you are less than secure in the way you feel. I love to sing. I love it. I don't know what I'd do if I didn't sing. But it's very uncomfortable for me to sing in public, and it always has been. And I think most people recognize it, and they sort of gotten to accustomed to certain mannerisms that I have.
Come running, come flying, come laughing, come crying, but come back, baby, just as fast as you can. Come standing, come falling, come creeping, come crawling, but get here, baby, just as fast as you can. I thought when you were gone, I'd carry on, but honey, my heart was an idiot, and I didn't know when I let you go, I'd miss you so the next minute. Come running, come riding, come slipping, come sliding, but come back, baby, just as fast as you can. I'd carry on, but honey, my heart was an idiot. I didn't know I let you go, I'd miss you so the next minute. Come smiling, come pouting, come yelling, come shouting, but come back.
I'm totally lost when it comes to the end of the song. I don't know what to do. I do terrible things, but there's nothing to do. You know, I can't pretend that it was the best thing that I'd ever done, because, you know, I sing every night. I sing constantly, and hopefully you can maintain a level of consistency about your singing, which isn't which is a little above average, but certainly you can't sing terrific every night.
You have a very mobile face. Some of the contortions, maybe that's a bit of a cruel word.
Oh, it's true. It's true. My mouth is too big. My lips are too big.
But sometimes with very tender songs, you twist your face around. Yes. Is that anything to do with the nerves, or is this some sort of transportation into the lyrics?
It's because when I was very young, as I say, I came from a large family, and we didn't have any money. I like to say we weren't poor, we just didn't have any money. But we had to go to free clinics, which is what you people in Great Britain have. But we had it in a very small way in the United States. And so instead of taking a cavity in my tooth and filling it, or digging it out and filling it, he would just pull the tooth. So he pulled all my teeth on this side, all the way around, when I was about 13 years old. Mm. So therefore I had a natural displacement of the jaw, so that in order to open my mouth, I had to twist it in a very contorted way. And that was a very bad thing to do when you're on a motion picture screen or on a television screen. So I suffered a great deal of criticism from the critics for a very long time. And then finally, I just got angry and I told him, I said, well, you know, I have a deformity. I can't help it.
Packing my grip and I'm taking a trip out of town over the weekend. Must have a change from the sight of this strange, lonely town over the weekend. Far from the noise of the crowd, there must be some place for me where I can shout to the clouds, shout that I'm free. Time and the world will stop. I know what I'll find. Love uninhibited, nothing prohibited. If it's insane, I don't care. Let me lose my mind. Monday will seem as unreal as a dream in the night. Over the weekend, back on the train, I could never explain my delight. Over the weekend, will I have any regret? Back in my hole in the wall, how long before I forget the thrill of it all? I think that I can hold on to love when it's over and gone. I'll let the curtain descend.
Life wasn't poor, but there wasn't much money. What was the Mathis household like?
Well, it was pandemonium. Nine people living in 5.5 rooms in a basement flat in San Francisco. San Francisco was very glamorous, of course, but we were not part of the glamour. It was time spent in... our recreation was always concerned with the church, school, and free type of institutions like the YMCA, the Boys Club, and that type of thing. I was constantly auditioning for scholarships, anything, scholarships for $25 or $10 or $5, anything that would help me get through school. The big times, the most important times in our lives were situated around Thanksgiving, Easter, and of course Christmas. Mm-hmm. And that's why when I did get an opportunity to record a lot of music, so much of it that I've recorded has been religious music and Christmas music, because that's the time that I remember the best.
Are you still a very religious person?
I think so, yeah. I think that's the overriding feeling that I have about why things have gone the way they have. It's it keeps me, I think, it keeps me content.
Beautiful sound I ever heard. All the beautiful sounds of the world in a single word. And suddenly that name will never be the same to me. Maria, I just kissed a girl named Maria, and suddenly I found how wonderful a sound could be. Maria, say it loud and there's music playing. It's soft and it's almost like playing. Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria.
Sudden opportunity to earn money and tour and turn your voice into a method of obtaining revenue. I mean, was that a shock?
Well, I never saw any of the money, and I still really don't deal in money. We make, my business partner and I, we make tours, concert tours. We come to Great Britain, for instance, because there's such a great compassion for me and my music here, especially among certain people like the Mathis connection. And so naturally you sort of go where people like you. But I never really thought about the money. It's always something that is that I've been fortunate with and never had to worry about. I had a lady who started me out in my career who was very good at managing money, mine and hers. So I've never really had to worry about it, and it's been a very fortunate thing for me because it has made me free to be able to sing and express myself in a way so that I wasn't pressured into doing something or singing a song or doing a performance that I didn't particularly want to do. I've always really wanted to do whatever I've done, and I think perhaps that has something to do with the outcome of it.
The lady, Helen Noga, virtually, from what I can make out, sort of sponsored you in those early days. And then there was a split.
She was like a surrogate mother, yes. And then all of a sudden I grew up. She found me when I was about 13 years old. And I was with her until I was about 23 or 4.
But this was an important split in the sense that it actually saw you managing your own affairs.
Well, I had to do something, didn't I? I really had to grow up and to realize that she was not my mother. She was someone who was a good friend who believed in me. But for instance, I lived in her house until I was 24 years old, I think, or even longer, with her husband, her daughter, and her granddaughter. And it was interesting, but not much fun for me because I had no life of my own. She scrutinized all my my friends, and I thought it was just time for me to get out and live. So anyway, it was kind of a difficult split, but we are very good friends now. She has written a book. Thankfully, the book has not been about me. She wanted to write a book about me, and I said no. First of all, it's not very interesting, but she was the person, besides my father, who's the most important two people in my life. I think without Helen Noga, there would not be a Johnny Mathis.
I was born in San Francisco when the bay was full of cruisers, where the west wind smells of fishing boats for 50 miles around. My father wore a crew cut. He was lean and he was handsome, and my mother wore such as yellow roses on her gown. They would walk me down from Spring Street past cathedrals on the hillsides, and the carillons would fill of anyone in town. I remember how they looked then, when their eyes were always living, when my father loved a girl with yellow roses on her gown. Then we moved to Placer County, where the weather was a joker, and I watched my parents' laughter turn from amber into ice.
My father never stumbled. He would tell me things would change soon. He would bear and bear the insults of a pair of loaded dimes. And my mother stood beside him, though her heart was on the hillside of a city where a soldier and his love. And at night, amid the whisper of the pines and manzanita, she would cry into a sash of yellow roses on her gown. By the Sacramento River, and he swears to me he's happy with his practice and some land. In the springtime and the summer, when the fog is off the valley, I visit him on weekends. His grass is overgrown, sometimes after dinner I would gaze away the evening in the attic at a sash yellow roses on her gown.
You do get lonely in this business, but that's part of it. It's part of being in a business that's about fantasy. And that's what this business is about. I love my music, but it's all fantasy. It is not really reality.
I mean, the pictures of the beautiful house and the dog, and I mean, that's all very nice. And I don't want to paint a picture of the sad Mathis who goes home from the concerts.
But I'm not sad, and I do... I did have a dog, but he died. That's sad. I do have a wonderful home that I'm very proud of, and I spend a great deal of time there, and it gives me, I think, the most pleasure in the world to go to my home and to spend time doing things that I like doing, like cooking and playing golf and gardening and spending time with friends. But a lot of the time, in fact, most of the time, is spent touring, traveling. And of course, I have to be—I have to truly be what I say I am, and that is a performer who works at his craft. And there just isn't any time for anything else.
My brain till it was clean. When
I was up, they knocked me down. I ain't gonna hang around, I'm going home. I'm going home, going home. Tell someone to meet me, coming home. Never got the chance to prove myself, don't try to play their game. But using people just ain't my thing. I won't dangle from any string to please some fool I don't care about. They've turned me inside out. I'm going home. I'm going home, going home. Tell someone to meet me, coming home. I'm going home.
Sometimes watching you on stage, I got the impression that, you could almost be oblivious to the audience being there, that you were almost still alone with the song. And how do you come across to the audience? I mean, how do you cut through the pressures of say, touring and walk out and meet a new audience in a new, friendly way?
I think so much of it has to do with if you really, really like what you're doing, if you enjoy it. I love to sing. Most of the songs that I sing are rather romantic, and some of them are very sad type songs. But I'm just that kind of person, and there are people in the world like me. I've had some talks with very famous people who are a little reticent, a little less than outgoing, and they find it difficult to travel in the public spotlight when they're that way. But it's not something to feel sorry for someone
no,
about.
No, no,
it's just that that's the way I am, and it's the way I feel comfortable in life. I would be very uncomfortable if I were any other way. In fact, as the years go on, I get a little bit more reclusive. That's not a good word. I get less public. But I think everybody's that way. They finally find in life something or a few things that they enjoy doing. And they say, okay, I've done all the other things that everybody else wants me to do, so now I'll do a few things that I like to do. And I really and truly enjoy being quiet and being rather alone as opposed to lonely.
Right. You've talked about the two most important relationships you've had, but you must also have some very close relationships with the people around you, thinking principally of producers and arrangers, and the people who come on tour with you. What about arrangers? You are now in charge of your own destiny, you're able to choose your own songs and where you tour, and and you've got good control over your career, but is there a point where an arranger actually takes over and you've actually got to step back and say, yes, that's right?
Yes, there's a wonderful moment that happens when you meet an arranger or a producer, and they're sometimes one and the same person, oftentimes they're not. But it's a wonderful moment when you say, oh, thank God, this person knows exactly what they're doing, and they know me, they know my capabilities, and they know my my shortcomings. And you feel absolutely perfectly at ease with them. And that's a wonderful time.
Anyone in particular?
Oh, yes. The first one was Mitch Miller, who absolutely knew my voice. He knew what would be right for it. And he was not the most compassionate person, not because he didn't try to be, it's just that it wasn't in his nature. But he did know what suited me. So he started me out singing songs. The first songs I ever sang were, under his tutelage, were Wonderful, Wonderful, Chances Are, It's Not For Me To Say, The Twelfth Of Never, When Sunny Gets Blue. And he knew my feelings, my innermost feelings, and he found these songs and he just let me go. Then there were people that, like Percy Faith, who knew how to accompany my voice without swallowing it up or without making it too out of proportion. That was followed by people like Glenn Osser. I went through a wonderful period of singing with some of the finest arrangers and composers like Don Costa, Ray Ellis. It just goes on and on. Up to today, when I've done most of my recordings with Gene Page, who is a very sensitive person, and now I've got another brand new producer who has found that quality in me that he can relate to, and it's wonderful when that happens. It doesn't happen all the time.
When the loving goes out, of the loving, and there isn't a thing you can do, but reminisce of yesterday, second guess her changing ways, and fill your time with people just like you. When the loving's gone out, of the loving's gone, and there is a thing that you can say, bite your tongue and wonder why, and then you watch your life flash by, hoping things will turn around your way. There isn't a loving thing I can say, there isn't a loving thing I can do, there isn't a I can never reach you.
I can never reach you.
How can I walk away and feel free when loving you means my whole life to me? There isn't a loving way I can ever leave you and be free. When the loving's gone out of the loving, and there's no easy way to
It's a fascinating show that you do, because at one moment you might just be accompanied by one instrument, and the rest of the time you really do move with the orchestra. What is the basis of working with an orchestra?
The thing that I like to try to do is to show the different components that make up an entire orchestra. I have had the pleasure of working with a really outstanding artist, Gil Rigers, who plays the acoustic guitar. Well, I like for him to play the acoustic guitar. He likes to get into a lot of heavy metal. But I like the sound of the acoustic guitar and the voice alone. I also like the sound of the voice and just the harp, or the voice and just the acoustic piano. So that when the strings come in, or when the horns come in, say, you have something to compare it to. If you have it all at once, all the time, it can be a little monotonous. So I like to utilize that by singing very softly sometimes, sometimes almost in a whisper. Mm. And then at other times, doing what most musicians do and make a joyful noise, just as loud as I can sing, and as far as I can sing. But I like to have the two combined, and then somewhere in the middle there's also something to be said.
And you also have a microphone technique which is very interesting. I mean, you play the microphone as an instrument as well in many respects.
Well, it is. It's there to assist you. It isn't there to be abused. Some people just sing with it.
Sort of gobble it up.
Like that all the time. Yeah, that's. I think it's very uninteresting. You can get so many shades of colors by putting it at different places. Sometimes I keep it here. But I also have the great joy of having an artist with me by the name of Kirk Robbins, who runs all the sound for me and has been for years. He knows when I'm going to do this and when I'm going to do that and what have you. And it's all a matter of having good friends around you who help you do all these wonderful things that people think you do on stage. Mm-hmm. And actually, it's a matter of a lot of people cooperating and working together.
If it's magic, then why can't it be everlasting? Like the sun that always shines, like the poets in this rhyme, like the galaxies in time. If it's pleasing, then why can't it be never leaving? Like the day that never fails, like on seashores there are shells, like the time that always tells. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every thirst. So, if it's special, then with it, why aren't we as careful as making sure we dress in style, posing pictures with a smile, keeping danger from a child? It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every thirst. If it's magic, why can't we make it everlasting? Like the lifetime of the sun, it will leave no heart undone. For there's enough for everyone.
Subject of vocalising, I mean, in those early days when you were talking about scholarships and things, there was a very good chance that you would be an athlete. You might even have gone to the Olympics. Do you look upon your voice and your throat and whatever makes that very distinctive noise? Do you look upon it the way that a runner would regard his vital legs and lungs? I mean, are you a vocally a keep fit enthusiast?
Yes. when you talk to athletes or you talk to singers, you're speaking of something that is a physical, something that is very physical. Singing is the most physical thing that I know that anyone can do, because it requires a great deal of strength, physical strength, but it also requires a great deal of finesse and control. You have to control in order to sing loudly and softly. They're completely different muscles. A lot of different muscles. And it's kind of silly to sit around and talk about it, because anybody who sings and sings well knows what a physical effort it is. And so it's been kind of good for me that that some of the discipline that I had as a youngster, as a high jumper and a hurdler and a basketball player, has stood me in good stead later on, in order to have the physical strength to be able to sing for as long as I have, because really Mother Nature didn't intend for the voice to be used as much as some of us have to use it.
Happens because the world is waiting for one child. Black, white, yellow, no one knows. But a child that will grow up and turn tears to laughter, hate to love, war to peace, and everyone to everyone's neighbor. And misery and suffering will be words to be forgotten forever. It's all a dream, an illusion now. It must come true sometime soon, somehow. All across the land dawns a brand new morn. This comes to pass when a child is born. A dream, an illusion now, it must come true. a song would sing. Why don't you sing it? Life is a song worth singing. Why don't you sing it? You hold the key in the palm of your hand. Use it. Don't blame your life on a master plan. Change it. Sing it. Why don't you sing it? You don't like the way you're living. Go to bed. You can't change your life because it's out of your hands. So sad. Sensation, drive a big expensive car. I would buy you everything your little heart desired. These things I'd do, cause I'm stone in love with you. I'd sit behind a desk. I'd be so successful. I would scare Wall Street to death. I would hold a meeting for the press to let them know I did it all, cause I'm stoned. Man, doing everything the best I can. What if I could give the world to you? I'd like to someday be the owner of the first house on the moon. There would be no neighbors and no population boom. You might say that all I do is dream my life away.
Your philosophy as far as the fans are concerned?
Well, first of all, they are people who are sort of like myself. I've found that to be true. They are sensitive, not tended to be too demonstrative, except on rare occasions when we all get together, when all of us get together. I like to think of them as friends who happen to share the same interest as I do in music. They certainly are more than just your casual friends. They are friends who are dedicated to letting other people know about your work, as they have been. And they're people that I admire, as I think, as much as they admire me. I admire them because they can sit through so many shows, 6-7 shows in a row, and they find the same sort of diversion in the music that I find, because I, let's face it, I have to sing the same songs sometimes over and over and over again for 6 weeks or 7 weeks, and I have to find something within this music to stimulate me to get a reaction from the people. So I certainly can't thank the connection enough for all these wonderful tributes that you've given me throughout my entire tour throughout Great Britain. I've seen you in Scotland, I've seen you in the south of England, I've seen you in the north, I've seen you everywhere with your banners and with your good wishes, and it makes me feel like an Englishman. Says thank you, Johnny, for 25 years of beautiful song, our love and devotion, the Mathis Connection. These people in the Mathis Connection have shown me that it isn't me, and it isn't the music. It's just everything. It's a combination. Their feeling for me, my feeling for them, and both our feelings for the music that that I perform. So it's a special type of relationship that we have, which is almost impossible to verbalize. But I would like to say to Joe Baker and her society that it's my privilege to have known all of them. All right, we'll try this. My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart. Unphotographable, yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak? And when you open it to speak, are you smart? But don't change your hair for me. If you care.
Valentine's Day.
You could have opened a florist on
well,
the strength
I,
of...
I did say, except on certain occasions.
Yes. Yes. And in fact, there's quite a bit of charitable work which is done by these Mathis supporters.
As I say, they find a way to show me their humanitarianism by the things that they've done. They've done some incredible things. Just this last tour here in Scotland... the society up there got a hold of an old dilapidated bus. Is that what you call it?
Yes.
A bus? Okay.
What would you call it?
Well, I don't know. You know, you guys call a truck a lorry.
Yes, that's true. Yes, all right.
We call a lorry a truck.
Yeah, a bus.
Okay, a
did
bus.
Did it have an upstairs?
No, it didn't.
It was a coach.
See?
Sorry, right. I don't speak the language very well.
So they got a coach, and they completely stripped it apart, spent lots of time and money and worked on it themselves. They put an elevator in it and presented it to some basketball players who happen to have a handicap. They, you know, they haven't got as many legs and arms as we have, and yet they play basketball. And they travel all around the country playing basketball. So they got this coach, and they... And yet they ride on it, you know, after they do all the work and spend all the time. They ride on it, you know, presented by the Mathis connection. Those are special people, and I really appreciate them.
Do they help at all with the golf support?
Well, they do what they can. They come
maybe
to the,
you don't need it.
They come to the tournaments. One lady who came to the tournament... unfortunately got hit and injured very badly, not as badly as I thought. I thought she was dead. I really did, because we heard the thud that hit her head from the golf ball, and it's only because these people were paying their respects to me to come to the golf match, but they didn't know where to stand. They didn't know that you couldn't stand in front of someone like... Oh,
it wasn't Gerald Ford again.
Well, well, it could have been, couldn't it? Yeah, and it wasn't Terry Wogan. Terry played very well that day, I know, because I played with him. But there are some people who play in these celebrity tournaments who haven't a clue as to how to hit the golf ball, and these people trust them implicitly, and they'll hook it or they'll slice it, and you can get very bad injuries. So anyway, the society comes to the golf matches, and I'd just like to say to them, to be very careful. We all aren't all farmers.
What are you playing off now?
I'm playing off nine.
Did you like that? I don't know a thing about golf, but I thought that was the expression that
you said. You said that very well.
Jolly good.
Yeah.
Keeping my eyes on the road, I see you. Keeping my hands on the wheel, I hold you. Ninety-nine miles from L.A. I kiss you, I miss you, please be there. Passing a white sandy beach, we're sailing, turning the radio on, we're dancing. 9 miles from L.A. I want you, I need you, please be there. The windshield is covered with rain, I'm crying, pressing my foot on the gas, I'm flying. mounting the telephone poles, I phone you. Reading the signs on the road, I write you. Miles from L.A. We're laughing, we're loving, please believe it.
I think I look better if I'm thin as opposed to fat. I like to be able to look the part. If you're going to sing a love song or something, you have to look something like, I don't know.
Fanciable for all those ladies.
Yeah,
who
well, something, yeah.
Do you imagine when you're singing a love song that those ladies out there are sort of fantasizing over
no,
you?
No,
they
no.
Want
you
back
know what
in
I think about
nice
when I
house?
Sing? I think about the damnedest things when I sing. I think about what I'm going to have for dinner, if in fact I'm going to have dinner after the show.
Is this a wise confession? Is it going to ruin some of the atmosphere?
Well, it's the truth. Sometimes I, almost all the times, I think about exactly what I'm singing. But not all the time.
So maybe in the Twelfth of Never or something, it's hamburger, egg and chips, isn't it?
Well, it wouldn't, be hamburger, egg and chips for me. It would be maybe a sukiyaki or something. I like to eat really, really nice things. And
you're very keen on cooking, aren't you?
Well, I love to cook, yeah, but I like really good food, and I like food that isn't too fattening, naturally. But I do wander sometimes when I think, and sometimes I forget the words to the songs because I say, oh, my... And I've suddenly blown it. And I used to think, as a youngster, of course, you'd think things like that, it's going to ruin your career and the whole world is going to end. But it doesn't. It really doesn't. Mm. It's just something that happens, and you have to get over it quickly and just go ahead to something else. But as long as that's all that happens on the stage.
Lately I have had the strangest feeling, with no vivid reason here to find. Yet the thought of losing you's been hanging around my mind. Far more frequently, you're wearing perfume. Would you say no special place to go? But when I ask, Will you be coming back soon? You don't know, never know. Well, I'm a man of many wishes. Hope my premonition misses, but what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. Cause this time could mean goodbye. Lately I've been staring in the mirror, very slowly picking me apart, trying to tell myself I have no reason with your heart. Just the other night, while you were sleeping, I vaguely heard you whisper someone's name. But when I ask you of the thoughts you're keeping, you just say, nothing's changed. Well, I'm a man of many wishes, hope my premonition misses, but what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. This time could be goodbye, goodbye. I'm a man of many wishes, hope my premonition misses, but what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they
thank you very much. I'd like to try to recreate two songs that I recorded very recently with two very charming young ladies. And I invited them here tonight.
Yes.
So close your eyes and fantasize because they're not here. First, think of Jane Oliver, lovely motion picture song that we did. And then Deniece Williams, First, Jane Oliver.
Hello. I don't even know your name, but I'm hoping all the same.
This is more than just a simple hello.
I quoted before the night is through. I'll be talking love to you, meaning every word I say.
Oh, the last time I felt like this, I was falling in love. Falling and feeling I'd never fall in love again. Yes, the last time. Call it a day. Sorry that it has ended this way. No reason to pretend we knew it had to end someday this way.
Guess it's over.
What does the future have? Are there any more mountains? Are there any more challenges, really?
I've never really thought about what I was going to do other than to plan, oh, say, a concert tour of Great Britain about a year in advance, and I know that I have to do that. But as far as what I'm going to do, I don't know. It's what I do is simply try to make myself available for opportunities that are going to present themselves. And it's a terrible way to make your, you know, to live your life. But that's the life of anybody in this business. There's nobody who can tell you, actors and actresses and singers, dancers, you just are at the mercy of whether anybody wants to hear you or see you or not. And what you do is you just wait until someone comes along and says they want to see you in Australia, and you say, thank God, yeah. Well, that's about it.
And if the phone didn't ring, what would you do?
And if the phone didn't ring, I'd still sing. I'd sing for it, whoever. But mostly, I think I'd probably find something else to do.
But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. I saw you back from outer space. I just walked in to find you with that sad look upon your face. Should've changed that stupid lock, should've made you leave your key. Not alone for just one second, you'd be back to bother me. Go on now, go, walk out the door. Did the kind of lay down and die? Oh, Lord, I don't smile. Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'm still alive. I've got all my love to live. I've got all my love to give, and I'll survive. I will survive. Of my broken heart. But then I spent so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head high and you see me, somebody new. I'm not that chained up little person still in love with you. And so you felt like dropping in and just expect me to be free. Well, now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me. Oh, now go, walk out the door. Just turn around now, you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to crush me with goodbye? Did the guy crumble? Did the guy lay down and die? Oh, no, that I will survive. Oh, as long as I know how to live, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live. I've got all my life to give. Petrified, kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong. I learned how to get along and soar back from outer space. I just walked in to find you with that sad look on your face. Should have changed that stupid lock, should have made you leave your key. I don't know, for just one second, you'd be back bothering me. Go on now, go, walk out the door. Just turn around now, you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one to try to hurt me with your body? Did the guy crumble? Did the guy lay down and die? Oh, Lord, I will survive. Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live. I got all my love to give, and I'll survive.
a last song for you. If if you can think of me as a cat. Oh, but a very scruffy, scruffy cat. Not a calico.
Midnight, and the sound from the pavement. Has the moon lost her memory? She is smiling alone.
Understand what happiness is. Look, a new